Hey, people. What is up? Okay, so in just a moment, I am going to call out a brand name. And whenever I say that brand name, there's going to be an image, a thought that pops into your head immediately. I want you to save that. So, are you ready? Cold Steel. What do you think about when you think about Cold Steel? Exacto, they sold the company and now all their knives are going to be shit and end up at Walmart next to the Gerbers. Eh, maybe. Maybe not. We don't know yet. But if you're anything like me, whenever I think about Cold Steel, I think about things like this. You know, the pinnacle knives, right? The big folders, the tough folders. Here's my EDC for today. Things like that, right? Just Demco, Triadlock, durable, beefy, right? But there's other cold steels. There's some of the forgotten cold steels. Now, that's not to say that the one we're going to talk about in this video, which you know what it is because you read the title, right? It's not to say that that one is forgotten about, so to speak. It's just I think people think more about those ones I just showed, things like that, you know, the Recon ones, the Rajahs, the Holdouts, the whatever, you know, just all the normal cold steels. But I feel like this one doesn't necessarily get the love. I think sometimes people just forget about it or dismiss it as just a cheap knife. Is it a cheap knife? Yeah, it's a cheap knife, but it's not a cheap knife. You know what I mean? This is the Cold Steel Tough Light, and it's the one I'm going to be talking about. Now, I may or may not have done a review in the past on the Mini Tough Light, and or the Mini Tough, which whatever it's called. I don't know if it was light, but it was mini, and it was tough, and it was a good knife. This is a better one. It's a little bit bigger, a little bit better size for me personally. I do like small knives, but this one's a little bit more in line with what I like to carry daily, possibly even as a primary. And I feel like this knife doesn't necessarily get the love that I think it should. Now, hypothetical. What if Cold Steel goes in a different direction and they start making more like this? And you start seeing things like this at Walmart. Would I be mad at them? Yeah, I'd still be mad at them. But the saving grace is this is a really good knife. And this is a $30 knife, something like that. And I would still say that, you know, they have some things to offer if they went that route. Now, what is this knife? Well, you got the Grivex or the Grivery handles, right? Grivex, whatever you want to call it, the shit is tough. It is as durable, if not more so, than Spyderco's FRN. And I've never had a problem with Spyderco's FRN. A lot of people look at these things, these kind of materials, and they're like, oh, it's just plastics. Well, perhaps, but they're very glorified plastics. They're much better than a lot of people give them credit for. I get people like the premium feel. You like the, you know, the G10s and the carbon fibers and the aluminum. And I get it. I do too. But for a usable knife, this stuff's durable. So then you got Aus-8, which I've long said Cold Steel's Aus-8 is some of the best in the biz. They know how to heat treat it. So you got Aus-8 on it. You got Gravery, $30 knife, good size. You know, it's not maybe what you think of when you think of Cold Steel, but it is also a good Cold Steel. And, you know, if you look at one of my favorite EDCs, not necessarily, excuse me, dying. Okay. Not necessarily my favorite one of the platform, the native, I'm saying, the native 5 lightweight. I have it in so many flavors. This is the S90V version, but it's every bit as good a knife as this as far as usability. Blade steel, no. This is gonna win, but as far as the way it works, the way it cuts, the way it feels, yeah, the durability, I would even imagine. Some might argue that the Alsaid is more durable a work knife than the S90V, but then I'll just pull out the Rex 45 Native and we'll just squash that. But either way, what are you looking at? FRN, plastic, right? And no liners. And a small package, a small adhesible package. You got the double finger choil, you got the good top here for your thumb if you need to do that kind of thing. Very much the same. You got the dual finger choil, the lightweight, good ergonomics. Now this one right here, also no liners, gives it a nice lightweight for EDC. So I would say it's just as good a platform as the Native is. Now that kind of leads me to, would I rather see this knife in better steels? Absolutely, because I'm a steel guy. I love steels. That's one of the reasons why I love Spyderco, for example, because they do so many different blade steels, give you an option. I'd like to see that here, but if we're talking about a good, budget EDC knife, hey, I'm not mad at their Alsaid at all. You got the hole opener, or well, the we'll call that a peel, the peel opener, as opposed to the hole. Works the same. Good action. Can you flick it out? Let's see. Yep, you can flick it out. Lock up. It's a triad lock. It's a miniature triad lock. I don't need to say no more about that. So, jimping's all right. Spyderco's jimping is better. Again, we're not doing a comparison. I wanted to, a lot of us love this knife, right? The Native is a classic. And I just want to bring this in and say that this is just as good as it. Not for all the reasons, but as far as a usable knife. As far as the cutting edge on this, it's a hollow grind. I don't know if you can tell. So it slices real well. The edge is amazing on it, the factory edge. My edge is a little better than that. But as far as the performance, it may not hold the edge like some of your others, but it'll hold a really good edge. It'll take a really good edge. And for a work knife that's $30 or less, I don't think you can really ask for much more. It's got the Wharncliffe, or is that a sheep's foot? I don't know. There's so many different variations. It's a sheep's cliff. There you go. A worn foot. No, I don't like that. That one sounds weird. Sheep's cliff. And it always presents that edge into the medium you're cutting, just like any other Wharncliffe. I talk about this all the time. It gives you that real good action, and it's a hollow grind, so it cuts like a Yojimbo or the Smok. Just similar knives. Excuse me. Dry throat. So the performance is really well, really good. As far as edge retention, it's better than a lot of the ACR 13 that I've used. A lot of people want to say this is analogous to ACR 13. I don't think it is from Cold Steel. I think their Alsaid is just better overall. It is a Taiwanese Cold Steel, so the fit and finish is there. Again, you got the triad lock, so the lockup is there. The ergonomics are there, the performance. The only thing I don't like about this knife, and maybe some of you seen it already, where's the pocket clip? Look at that. Why? Why you gotta be there? No. They put this big peel-shaped lanyard hole. Continuity, right? Goes with the blade, I guess. So as far as design continuity, it's cohesive in that way. As far as being there, I don't want it there. What the hell do you need to put through this? I could put my belt through this damn thing. It's like, it's there. I get it. Some people like to put crazy shit through their knife. Not me. I talk about it on the paramilitary, on the para three. You got the hole, you got the lanyard hole. The lanyard hole is impeding my pocket clip placement, but at least they're back there. This one's up here, and you got tip down. Now, is that a deal breaker? No. I still like it. I just carry it in a different way, So, it's not a deal breaker. It's the only thing I don't like about it, though. What else? Where else do I need to go? This one, they got it in different colors, of course. I believe black, blue, red, maybe others. I don't know. But the black and the blue and the red, I've seen those for sure. I like the red. I had the black one. I like a little color, if it's not obvious. The blade stock. Yeah. A little tiny bit thinner than the native. The native is a distal taper. The distal taper, of course, is gonna give you a little bit different performance, but as far as the blade stock on this, it's good. It's not overly thick, it's not overly thin. And of course you got the hollow ground, so it does come to a very thin edge. I like that. The comfort. I'm having a breakdown over here. I need a drink. Comfort is excellent. This is probably one of the most ergonomic knives in my collection. Just the way it feels is amazing. And I guess what I'm trying to get at is just don't overlook this one. If you know this one, cool, you know what I'm talking about. It's a hell of a little work knife. It's something you're not afraid to beat up or something you're not afraid to lose necessarily. I mean, I would feel bad if I lost a $10 knife because, I don't like loss, but it's just one of those knives you don't have to worry about so much. And it's built well. It's built just as good as anything. So, that's my thoughts on it. That's what I think of the Tough. It is. And if that's the kind of knives they made going forward, sure, I would miss the knives like this. But I would also probably like some of the stuff they do. With that, I'm gonna get out of here. I gotta go have a drink before I choke to death. I'll talk to y'all later. Life's short. Stay sharp.